responsible to be out of your parents' house.
I think your question should be, what's wrong with Singaporeans?
But it's not a very transparent system because there are a lot of hidden charges. By the time you add on, I think it depends where you're coming from. With the morning charges, I mean, I take the cab, but it's getting more unaffordable because...
This is more in relation to the cabs, but I think in a way, the public transport, it is relatively cheaper compared to some of the other countries.
Yeah.
But I agree with you. Yeah, in terms of taxis, the embedded costs, depending on the time... and where you want to go, there's all these things that kind of factor in that you might not have taken into account before.
I'd like to argue against that because the cost of owning a cab, including the COE, as of 2013, like a taxi owner will pay about $95,000 per cab just to drive the taxi on the road. And compared to other countries, the taxi fares here still are...
Reason.
Including the amount that the guy is spending in it to get the taxi on the road is actually very doable. I mean, if you compare to Sydney or even like the United States, if you go to LA, like taxis are like unaffordable. So I think the taxis are still doing a pretty good job in Singapore.
Getting a cab is difficult. I mean, yeah, maybe the cost is not so high, but then if you want to get a cab, I mean, most of the time you can't get one. I mean, that's a frequent complaint.
Is it easier to get a cab in New York, in London?
It was very easy to get a cab in Bangkok or Hong Kong. There's no issue with that.
And it doesn't move.
Yeah.
So straight up, you get the cab, but do you get anywhere in the end?
But here is, I mean, we know the problem because here the structure, the renter is high per day, so you have two shifts, right?
Mm-hmm.
You can't drive a whole 24 hours, so you do the two shifts. And then most of the cases, because of the extra charges, like the 50% or 35%, so cabs sometimes hide themselves somewhere in order that they can wait till that midnight. I mean, before now, I think 11:30 onwards is already, you know, they started the charges, or even somehow earlier, like between 6:30 or 5:30 to 9:30. Then it's just so confusing, the charges, right? But basically, the cab will, because of getting higher income, they find all ways so that, you know, some area you just can't get a cab. I think I experienced it. It's very difficult to get a cab. You're very worried that you just can't find one when you need one.
Okay, now we're warming up. We've had some preliminary discussion. After the break, we want to go deeper into looking at the MRT in particular. I think Winston has lots of things to say. We also want to look at our taxi men. How efficient are they, and what kind of service we get from them. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.